In early 2007, Mika's debut album, Life in Cartoon Motion, went on to sell nearly 6 million copies and in turn released 6 million inner children. 2 years on, he returns with The Boy Who Knew Too Much, which is proving to be no less inspiring, but this time investigating the darker avenues of Mika's adolescence. Mika, hello.
Hello.
Thanks for having me here in your weird kind of Andy Warhol world that you've got going on.
If I look behind me, there's a man in a white boiler suit just sound checking a guitar.
These are all my friends.
These are all your friends. I'm fine with it. Absolutely fine with this.
And so let's talk about Life in Cartoon Motion, of course, your first album, your debut, which was very like in your face, like no nonsense, let's have a good time kind of album. Your new one, what's the vibe with that? It's a lot darker, The Boy Who Knew Too Much.
If you look at the first record and all this nursery rhyme references and the fairy tale references, and then you look at this new record, it's almost like the fairy tales are still there, they're just being looked at through a Tim Burton lens.
Right.
It's gotten a little bit more gothic, and nursery rhymes, they're actually really violent and dark. And so you're putting your baby to sleep, but you're actually putting it to sleep with a story about another baby dying. And it, like, kids dance around, like, talking, you know, singing about the plague. Like,
ring around the roses. Exactly. It's so weird.
It's really, but as a kid, you don't get it, you know?
Okay, we're going to go check out Rain, which I thought was kind of like a big dance floor anthem.
Yeah.
Was this specifically a
breakup letter, but I thought it would be funny to put it to a dance track. Yeah. And I wrote it, walked out, and never saw that person again. And then I thought it would be...
threw a dance beat under it.
Put a dance beat under it, just kind of compound it. You know, when I was younger, I used to write songs because I didn't have the guts to say things to people, to their face. Uh-huh. And I was always like, if you're going to put an insult in the song, at least put a catchy melody with it and you'll get them to sing it at you.
Yeah. You're just like, hey, I'm dancing. You're alone. Here it is. This is Mika and Rain.
Is it really necessary every single day? You're making me more ordinary in every possible way. Ordinary mind is broken. You did it and you don't even know. You're leaving me with words unspoken. You better get back, 'cause I'm ready for more than this, whatever it is. Baby, I hate days like this. I'm trying to try, I can't look back. Baby, I hate days like
So let's talk about this new character, Dr. John.
Yeah.
Who is this guy? So this is a guy on your album, it's a record on your new album, which is kind of a dark, sinister doctor.
It's like a witch doctor. Yeah. He's obsessed with voodoo. While I was younger, I had this fascination with dark magic.
Right.
And so he's this kind of shrunken head-wearing triangular man who lives in some forest surrounded by magic chickens, and I wrote a song about him.
It's the best thing I've ever heard, Mika. It's absolutely amazing. Should we check it out? This is Mika. This is you performing Dr. John.
Strange place from the back of a bar, from afar. I see the look on my mama's face when her son's in the corner undone. She says that my life is over. Oh boy, you don't know what you got till it's gone. Come put your head upon my shoulder. She gave me a hand, but I ignored her. Oh, Dr. John, what am I doing? What am I doing wrong? 'Cause I keep on trying. From afar, I see the look on my daddy's face when her son's falling over undone. Father, my life is over. Oh, I didn't know what I had, now it's gone. Can I lay my head upon your shoulder? If I fall asleep, will it be over? Oh,
okay.